wrote the first chapter of America's Amazing Story, our founding fathers, of course, and today is Founding Fathers Friday.
Joining us now to celebrate, you recognize him, third president of the United States and one of our country's founding fathers, Thomas Jefferson. Nice to see you, Mr. President.
Well, welcome. It's a pleasure to be with you.
Nice to have you as well. Even though you were one of the very first presidents of the United States, as you remember, you were a budget cutter, weren't you?
Well, I was. I believe that government needs to be simple and frugal. And when I became president in 1801, I inherited a debt of $83 million. When I left the presidency 8 years later, I'd reduced that $33 million.
That's right.
We are not only being irresponsible, but stealing from posterity, a posterity that we paid a great price to purchase liberty for that it seems that we're giving away.
I know that you've never seen a number that big that we just showed on the screen. That's something that's been created since you've passed.
Well, in the Declaration of Independence, which I hope all Americans have read, says that we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created and are endowed by their Creator. Those who founded this nation held to a set of truths. We believe there was truth.
When you look at maybe the modern American Tea Party, you look at these movements in the country to try to simplify government, what do you think? Does it harken back to your time?
Well, not only did I cut the deficit, but I also reduced the size of government.
Well, on this Founding Fathers Friday, we thank you, Thomas Jefferson, also known as Stephen McDonald, co-founder of the Providence Foundation and president of its Biblical Worldview University, actually lives in Thomas Jefferson's hometown right now. Sir, thank you very much.
Pleasure to be with you.
Founding Fathers Friday.
For spacious skies forever.